By its nature, TV's always been a kind of open door situation. Everyone in the room will know if you're watching something unsavoury. So TV makers and TV networks in general have to be careful about what gets broadcast, lest the ire of the moral guardians rain down on them.
As program makers, we'll be dealing with someone within a network, and they will have someone who is essentially the morals officer within the network. And they might come back with concerns based on a script or based on a cut, usually on a cut, which is where it becomes a bit more tricky if you haven't really, you know, got a way around it.
In 1971, the New Zealand Broadcasting Corporation received so many complaints about this Timberjack video, it was never shown again. But some TV never even makes it to broadcast. This is a documentary called If You're In It, You're In It to the Limit. It followed a biker gang, but the NZBC refused to play it due to the various types of antisocial behaviour on display.
Spewing in a jug of beer, drinking it down, you know, revolting things like that, which, you know, is just there to see the results and the expressions on people's faces.
Shot 7, take 1.
It also featured an abnormal amount of public malarkey with a pig's head. Likewise, a music video by the political punk band Riot 111 was refused airtime because it showed police violence. And this Hot Grits music video didn't make the cut because it depicted children drinking milk like adults drinking alcohol. But of all the things considered too dangerous for TV, one music video has become infamous. This is Stuart Page. He's a longtime director of documentaries and music videos. In 1987, he was making a video for seminal punk band The Skeptics and their song, AFFCO.
And I just thought, oh, we want to go and film some animals get slaughtered. Let's just go to the freezing works and ask them if we can do it. There was guys standing waist deep and these big tanks of blood, you know, ripping open animals and ships pouring out of them. And there's another guy whose job it was to put a chain around the skin at the back of the cattle's neck. And then the chain would just go flying up and the skin would just come pouring off in one piece. And he only had one arm because his arm got caught in that thing once.
In the mid-80s, the only outlet for local music videos was a late Sunday night show on TVNZ.
If you didn't get it played on Radio Pictures, no one would see it. So I got a, you know, one-inch dub made off, sent it off down TV New Zealand in an overnight bag, chuck it in, send it off.
Richard Driver was one of the hosts.
We sat in the viewing room and locked ourselves in, put it in. It sounded like The Skeptics right away. You know, there was this lovely image of a sheep eating, but the music was quite ominous and quite dark, but we thought this is fine. And then suddenly, within about 12 seconds of this playing, there was images of sheep being stunned on the killing line. They're being stunned to knock them out, obviously, before, so it's a humane form of killing them. And we thought, that's a bit harsh, and I could feel the tension in the room. And then another 10 seconds down the line, and they're getting their throats slit. And this was, you know, quite a, like, we've never had a video like this before.
Then I get a letter about a week later saying that the graphic scenes of animal slaughter, you know, too horrific for their program, and it might be something that happens in everyday life, but, you know, not necessarily good viewing for a TV program. And
so there was a little bit of a kind of kerfuffle about it that made everybody feel very uncomfortable, and the decision actually came down to Gary Ryan, the producer. He made the call, from my memory, that we would talk to Stuart Page, we would see if we could edit this, because he didn't want to play it in as that version. It was too raw.
So then I suddenly thought, you know, when they show various people's faces on TV, they would put that mosaic effect on them, you know, if they weren't, but now they blur it these days, but they used to put mosaic on there. And I thought, oh, that's quite cool. Maybe we'll just put mosaic over all the bits where the animals are getting cut, you know. Made another dub, sent that back. And I got a letter from Gary Ryan saying that he says it's actually worse with that on it than it was before. I don't know how that could be.
Over time, the banning of AFFCO has become notorious.
I was kind of pissed off with radio pictures in a way for just being so tame and not, like, you know, sticking their neck out. I got a good response from showing it in public, people, you know, raving about it. It sort of came, it had a life of its own in a way after that, even though hardly anyone had seen it. For me, it still stands up as probably one of my favourite things I've made, actually, yeah.
Just got me in the eye with his shuttle.
Whether it be swearing, grievous bodily harm, or the imbibing of drugs, people have always debated one question. Can the depiction of antisocial behaviour deform society?
There's a lot of gamers out there now playing a lot of violent games that aren't doing anything violent.
I think violence and the glorification of it is a bigger reason to censor.
And in that debate, our censors have a big part to play.
I think the minute censors start closing in, or, you know, being typecast as being in an ivory tower, you lose touch. And I think it's really important when you're restricting something as precious as the freedom of expression, you owe people reasons. So you have to be out there, and you have to explain why you're doing this.
This program was made with funding from New Zealand On Air.